Diaz at 5'5". A look now at the Fight Doctor RX, first from the point of view of Steve Cruz.
Cruz got to use superior ring generalship to make Paez miss and frustrate Paez with counter punches as he comes roaring in. As far as the champion Jorge Paez is concerned, he's got to use energy, strength, and balance to wear Cruz out. He swarms all over Cruz, smothering his counter punching, and he's got to overcome his innate shyness that's evident so far today.
And the IBF championship rule, scoring on the 10-point must system, handled by three judges. No three knockdown rule, no standing eight. Mandatory eight is in effect, and the bell cannot save the boxer in any round, including the 12th. That is a recent change in the rules by the IBF. And the judges, David McCullough from Texas, Juan Jose Ramirez of Mexico, and Patricia German of Nevada. So the home state and country of each boxer is represented. And now we're set for the introductions. Let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to you. Y a todos amigos latinos, bienvenidos aficionados al box. We welcome you to the El Paso County Coliseum as Forum Boxing Incorporated presents the IBF Featherweight Championship of the World, scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Introducing to you the main event referee in charge, Robert Gonzalez. All right, fans, here we go. Introducing to you on my left, fighting out of the blue corner. Entering the ring wearing lime green trunks and hailing from Fort Worth, Texas. He weighs in tonight 125.5 pounds with an outstanding record, 33 wins, 3 losses, 18 wins by way of knockout. He is the former WBA featherweight champion of the world, currently ranked number 3 IBF contender. Introducing the challenger, Steve Cruz. And introducing to you the champion on my right, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks with multicolor trim, hailing from Mexicali, Baja California, Mexico, with a weight 126 pounds. His fine record is 29 wins, 2 losses, 2 draws, 23 big wins by way of knockout. He is the defending IBF featherweight champion of the world, introducing the colorful Jorge Maromero.
Ferdy, you get the idea? The crowd has turned
outlandish in the ring. I've seen some crazy things but that Camacho wore, but this is really, really strange.
Well, Cruz represents one of the best punchers Paez has fought. The light-punching Calvin Grove hurt Paez, but Cruz has often been a slow starter. Let's see what happens here as we get underway. This for the IBF featherweight crown.
He's certainly not starting too slow now. He's fighting in retreat, but he's fighting very intelligently as this opens up with body shots.
Paez predicted a first-round knockout. He does have 6 first-round knockout victories. Got the left hook in, but Cruz able to counter.
Paez is very fast and very tricky because of the acrobat's balance. He can throw punches from any place. He's really incredible in how he throws punches.
The ring, but the referee Robert Gonzalez warned Paez for the holding behind the head. I would wonder if that dressing gown slows Paez down.
I would have the same thought. It's heavy, it's cumbersome. I just don't understand why anybody would allow it to begin with.
And we're being kind by labeling it a dressing gown.
Oh, they're trading heavy shots now. Both men landed solid hooks. Another solid hook by Paez.
Way through, scheduled for 12.
Neither man intimidated, both standing their ground. Cruz, as predicted, looking to counterpunch, looking to use some superior ring generalship. So far, he's shown it at the beginning of this round. Although Paez seems an irresistible force as he comes on, throwing these crazy punches from all angles.
Paez has lost twice in his professional career, both early in his career, both six-round bouts by decision. A right hand behind the ear of Cruz as Paez is beginning to heat up.
Oh, he wants this first-round knockout. He's going for a first-round knockout, and he's not saving anything up. Gotta admire the coolness of Cruz. Steve Cruz is just calculating, looking at him coolly, not intimidated by all this ferocity.
Coming up on 10 seconds to go, round number one. Good exchange. Leaping uppercut landed by Paez. Big finish for round one.
It is from...
This is round two. Marv Albert with Ferdy Pacheco from El Paso, Texas. How did you score that opening round?
I had to, off that big finish at the end, Paez seemed much stronger. Seemed had no regard whatsoever for Cruz's punching power. So I gave it to him 10-9. Cruz has got to do something more than lay on ropes when that attack comes. If he doesn't know how to get off those ropes when that vicious attack comes, he's going to be in some kind of trouble a few rounds from now.
And we have seen that Cruz has been ineffective when he's been forced to retreat, and Paez had him backpedaling at the end of that first round.
Backpedaling and not fighting effectively in counterpunch. It's one thing to backpedal, but you got to stop and fight every once in a while, and you got to keep this guy off of it. You know, this guy's a joke outside the ring, but inside the ring, he's no joke at all. He's fierce. Batman carved on his head, crazy socks and crazy skirt, but he is a warrior inside this ring.
Just over 1 minute gone by in round two.
Interesting to me is this virtual sellout crowd is booing Paez more in Cruz's corner.
And Cruz does hail from Fort Worth, Texas. Again, a good exchange. For an instant, it looked like he had Paez leaning. That blow grazed Cruz, but he did connect with the right hand.
It's just too much strength on the part of Paez. The champion looks like a champion in command. He just disregards anything Cruz does and then comes through it with his strength.
Close to a low blow thrown by Paez. His last fight was back in May. Paez with a 12-round draw against Louis Espinosa.
Oh, down goes Cruz! Beautiful counterpunch by Cruz. Perfect right hand by Cruz.
Paez does have an excellent chin. He had never been down, but Cruz put him down with the counter.
Some blood from the nose of Paez. Paez wants to fight it out. His fighting blood is up. What a perfect counterpunch by Cruz.
Final seconds. Second round. We'll be back in a moment.
Very low. You see that? An invitation for a right hand. Here comes Cruz. Perfect right hand. You invite him in, and he closed the show with that right hand. He almost knocked out Paez. Another view. And you see Paez recovered from that is an incredible monument to his strength.
Referee Robert Gonzalez had difficulty keeping Paez in his corner. Paez over Pius to make his way to the center of the ring. And again, Pius heard it from the crowd, a crowd that has turned against him after initial booing of Cruz as he made his way to the ring.
No question about it, this crowd is for the underdog.
The counter in the second round. Paez looking to defend his IBF featherweight crown. Cruz, a one-time WBA featherweight champion. Although Cruz does have decent power, out of his 33 victories, only 18 have been by the knockout route.
Cruz exhibiting a great deal of ring generalship here.
But Pius caught him. Pius got him with an uppercut.
If Pius ever had a game plan, it's out the window now. He's just fighting. This is just street fighting. He forgot boxing. He's thrown several that missed by a mile after one connected well.
The champ for Steve Cruz.
You sense it's not quite the energy and not quite the steam that Baez had in the opening round and the second round until he got clipped. He's fighting hard, but he hasn't got that same kind of confidence and strength that he had.
And just under 1 minute to go in this third round. Paez able to step it up here in the third. Left hook from Cruz, but did not get full impact.
Beautiful work off the rope by Cruz. Cruz getting hammered. Swarming attack by the champion.
Paez missed, though, on many of those blows.
Paez also hit on the break. He also hit with elbows, and he also put his hand in. That was a compendium of all kind of forces coming at Cruz.
And that is it for round three. Today's moments at the end of round three. Listen. Some debris also was tossed into the ring as round three came to a close. And now it's round number four, and they come out winging at each other.
Remember, Paez has never been down. It took him a round to realize he'd been down, and he's got to come back. He did come back in that last round. He didn't look as good as in the first, but he's pulled his fight even 28-28, quite unofficially on my scorecard.
Scoring is on the 10-point must system, handled by three judges. Jorge Paez defending his IBF featherweight title, 23 years old, from Mexicali, Mexico. A one-time circus clown and acrobat who put on a show in his entrance into the ring. And Steve Cruz, a bit more on the quiet side, 25 years old, from Fort Worth, Texas, and he just took that right hand from Paez.
Sharp right hand from Paez. Nice hook, left hook from Paez. Paez is beginning to connect on Cruz. Cruz, the referee just said, hey, no healing with the glove. These gloves are Reyes gloves. They're connected. The thumb is connected, so this diminishes the danger of thumbing. Move by the commission to use these kind of gloves. Remember, Paez is one of these border town guys, grown up in the heat, used to working hard from early morning to late at night, so he wants his fight to go long. He thinks the heat in here and the length of time will work against Cruz.
And Cruz also has done well, where there have been situations of very difficult hot conditions. And again, a warning
That's another warning for the elbow. He is hitting with an elbow. He is healing with the glove, and he's using his head, just as Cliff Gorman had warned the referee he would do.
You're talking of Dave Gorman. Cliff, of course, the accomplished actor.
I'm sorry.
Ferdy getting lost in the world of theater.
Well, it's getting exciting here. It's getting exciting as Baez continues his relentless chase of Cruz, and Cruz just won't be flustered. He is a ring general. He has been showing that. He's cool. He's getting hammered, but he is cool. Waiting for a shot.
Back to the point of fighting with oppressive heat. You'll recall that when Cruz defeated Barry McGuigan in Las Vegas, temperatures were over 100 degrees some 3 years ago. And this is round five from the El Paso Coliseum. Capacity crowd better than 6,500 on hand. Steve Cruz in the green trunks and the dressing gown. It is the champion, Jorge Paez.
And this is a lesson in scoring. So many times you keep your eye on the guy that's doing all the attacking, flashily dressed and throwing punches from all angles. Don't take your eyes off Stevie Cruz. He's doing a good job of ring generalship. He's baiting traps. He's setting traps for Paez. And when Paez comes in, he gets hit these sharp little punches. They take their effect, and they take their toll over the rounds. Paez is no longer bouncing around like an acrobat. He's walking around like a mere human right now.
Those of you who may have just tuned in, Cruz did put Paez down. In the second round, Paez came out very active in the third. The fourth, a relatively quiet round. And a minute gone by here in round five.
Disbelief on Paez's face when he went down was really something. He's never been down before. He had predicted a one-round knockdown, and here in the second round, he was down. Also important when you're scoring ring generalship is how many times he makes Paez miss. Punches that look great on your camera or on your screen are not landing.
That is what got him in trouble when he went down. The only knockdown of the bout that was back in round number one.
That's an open invitation to a straight right, which is what Cruz accepted the invitation and put him down.
Oh, low blow from Cruz. And again, the chanting first for Cruz and then for Paez. Jorge Paez began his professional career January of 85 in Mexico with a first round knockout. Of his 33 pro fights, only two have taken place out of Mexico, though we are nearby. This is number three out of his home country.
Well, not far from it. home country, a bridge away from his home country. I think it's amazing to me that it's equally divided. It seems they were just beginning to holler Maro Maro. For the first time, you've heard some support for Pius. Maybe they're starting to feel sorry that he doesn't show that cocky confidence that he did in that first round, but he's getting down to where he's frustrated and he's got to figure out a way. Again, a warning for the referee.
At the rules meeting yesterday, Cruz's people made it clear that they would like the referee to keep an eye on the so-called dirty tactics of Jorge Páez, and there have been a number of warnings for low blows and holding while hitting.
Cruz is maintaining that distance between the two that Páez finds so impossible to get close to. Just when he gets close, off goes Cruz. Once he gets his energy back, he's going to have to start rushing in as he did in that first round.
Obviously able to shake it off. Midway point, round number six, scheduled for 12.
No question about it, Cruz has been taking some very hard shots, but he takes it very well. Doesn't seem to affect him.
And now Páez connecting with the left hook.
And fighting while the referee was breaking them up, which is a no-no. I'm surprised he didn't get warned for that.
Robert Gonzalez, the referee, did not get the clean break, and that was to the advantage of Páez off that exchange.
Páez has absolutely got Cruz where he wants him. With his back to the ropes, Cruz is not sliding away. He's not giving him any spin moves. He's just standing there. That's to his disadvantage. That's exactly what Páez wants.
That was more of a shove by Cruz.
Things starting to go his way now. Páez is starting to get the kind of fight he wants. In close and savage. That inside uppercut is murder that Páez throws. He misses it most of the time, but when it connects, it does some damage.
And again, Páez effective inside with the uppercut, and then he'll lean on Cruz, and using his strength is able to pull him aside. And this is round seven for the IBF Featherweight Championship as Páez came out quickly
and established that uppercut again.
Nice job by Cruz to slip the punches of Páez.
He built up a lot of points right at there at the beginning of that round. Those were hard punches, especially the uppercuts, pinning Cruz to the ropes. Again, the left hand held very, very low by Páez as he comes in.
And in the featherweight division, the WBA title holder, Antonio Sparagos of Venezuela, who won his title by defeating Steve Cruz, Jeff Fennec of Australia, holds the WBC version of the crown.
It was an interesting combination. It proved what we were talking about, punches from all angles. When he's off balance, when one leg is up in the air, you just don't know what to expect from that. That's those great reflexes and balance you have as an acrobat.
Should be pointed out that Fennec, the WBC champion, is currently in retirement, but many people expect that he will make his return.
The fight is still very close on my unofficial scorecard, 57-56, Páez ahead. It could well be different on this diverse crowd of judges. I had the opportunity to talk to Judge Juan Ramirez from Mexico, who downgraded this bout, said it was very easy. It's going to be an easy bout for Páez. I thought that was kind of
curious.
Careless,
yes.
If not curious.
Most unusual for one of the judges to actually venture an opinion before the bout of a fight that he would be involved with.
Yeah.
And he is the judge from Mexico.
It'll be interesting to see the scorecard when this goes, or if this goes to a decision. Because if you're all seeing this fight with only Paez's eyes, he's doing pretty good. He's just pounding away. What you don't see is the ring generalship that makes him miss so much and put him on his duff. When Cruz landed, a perfect right hand.
Paez was at the other end of a controversial decision back in May, that 12-round draw with Luis Espinoza in Espinoza's hometown of Phoenix. Many thought that Paez won it handily. Paez did have weight problems for that fight against Espinoza. Not the case here today. Final seconds of the round.
Triple uppercut.
Rounds. Jorge Paez very relaxed on the apron of the ring, chatting with photographers, arguing with fans in the crowd.
He works the crowd. First he goes to one side, they cheer, then they go to the other side, he boos.
This is round 8. Marv Albert with the fight doctor, Freddy Pacheco, from El Paso, Texas. The El Paso Coliseum is packed. Capacity crowd, 6,500 on hand. Jorge Paez defending his IBF featherweight title against the one-time champion, WBA version, Steve Cruz.
And we're in a building that has no air conditioning. The expected intense heat for the lights has not materialized. We don't feel it that uncomfortable here. Maybe it's because we're sitting on a block of ice, and I don't feel as bad, but the ringside thermometer is reading 86 degrees, which is certainly not hot.
Certainly helps that you have two fans blowing in your direction, which most of the crowd does not benefit from.
Meanwhile, in the ring, Steve Cruz has stopped in the last two rounds doing what he was doing so effectively, which is counterpunching. He's actually been standing there watching as Paez gets braver and braver.
And once again, Paez with that left hand being carried very low, then goes into the peekaboo.
He's definitely blowing these middle rounds, and he's certainly going to need them at the end. Every one of Cruz's punches were caught by elbows or gloves just then by Paez. That's what happens when you're scoring a fight. You look at that. That looked like a good four-punch combination. It wasn't. In the meantime, he just got hammered by three good shots at Cruz.
And Paez very confident now, sensing that Cruz does not have much left in his punching power and saying, come on, come on.
And this is a Paez of the first round. This is the first time we've seen a little posturing.
Robert Gonzalo said, come on, fight. So Paez doing some showboating. He feels he has it under control against Cruz. Now the polo punch. All right.
His show business instinct is aroused, if not his killer instinct. Cruz is a block of ice. He just doesn't change expression or emotion. He just sticks to his game plan. He is a disciplined fighter, even though at this moment I have him losing this fight. Again, quite unofficially.
Uppercut followed by the left, landed by Paez. And then the right hand that grazed Paez. From El Paso, Steve Cruz taking much time in his corner while Paez sat down for 20 seconds and was ready to come out. And now putting on a show that may not be appreciated by all boxing fans.
All he's trying to do is antagonize and frustrate Cruz, make him challenge him to fight. This is, in a sense, a positive no mas. This is what happened with Duran and Leonard the second time. Frustrated by the inability to just lock this guy in a fight, he's starting to clown to make him come fight to him. And it's working a little bit because Steve has started to punch.
Well, Cruz told us before the fight he would not be distracted by the antics, but you wonder if he has anything left. He did connect with some hard punchers earlier in the bout, that Paez came on strong, particularly in the second and fourth round. Paez can get caught in this type of situation, but again, the question that can be raised, would it matter? Does Cruz have anything left to catch him with?
Well, it's always Paez's game plan to wear you out and then come on in the later rounds. So far, these middle rounds, oh, nice shot by Paez. These middle rounds have belonged to Paez. Nice uppercut again.
By Paez. He missed with that leaping first attempt, and then was able to connect with the left. Look out for the elbow, said the referee Robert Gonzalez. See this a longer distance than Paez and Cruz usually go. Round number 9 with less than a minute remaining.
I wonder if Cruz is being told in the corner how to avoid those uppercuts by keeping his glove under there, because he's getting hit by hard uppercuts. Again, an example of punching completely out of balance when he shouldn't have even thrown a punch and landing it, as Paez winged the left hook that landed. He was off his feet when he threw it.
Holding and hitting by Paez, the referee Gonzalez screened out.
Two or three driving uppercuts. Good shot by Cruz just then.
Final seconds. We'll be back here in El Paso in a moment. Insignia on each side of his head, looking a bit on the born side as we get underway here in round number 10.
I really think he should have come in wearing the Joker's makeup. Taking it off in the first round is more apropos. Who wants to hit the Batman?
How do judges usually react to showboating?
It depends on geography and relationship. If you're from Mexico and you're related, you think it's good and maybe even give a point. I really believe impartial judges go by what's going on in a fight. You can showboat so long as you're fighting with it. In his case, he's showboating because he's frustrated. He wants him to fight. What's this?
A timeout taken for repairs.
And the repair is being made by the referee himself. That's an oddity.
The showboat aspect, though, psychological, because in a close fight, there can be a referee who might not appreciate that and perhaps would not give the benefit of the doubt. That is not the case here, because it appears that Paez is well in front against Cruz.
I think it's the reason why you showboat. I mean, he's showboating because he's frustrated. He wants to get him in a fight, and so it's sort of semi-borderline permissible. You can't make fun of somebody. You can't degrade somebody. In a sense, as I said before, that's what the Nomas fight was with Leonard and Durant. Now, Durant felt that he was getting degraded because it wasn't a boxing match. Interesting matchup coming up between those two.
It was back in the first round that Cruz put Paez down for the first time in his career, that Paez came storming out in the third round. I should say, Paez went down in the second round and then came back strong in the third, and then Paez took the fight over from the fifth round on. We had one slow round, that was number 4, but it has been Paez throughout.
It's Paez on the attack. Steve Cruz trying to use ring generalship, slowly being worn down. The more effective punches are being landed by the incessant pounding of the champion.
Less than a minute left in round 10. It's scheduled for 12. Jorge Paez, 23 years old, out of Mexicali, Mexico. Record of 29-2, 23 by knockout. While Steve Cruz, 25 years old, hails from Fort Worth, Texas. Record of 33-3, 18 by knockout. His biggest victory, the upset over Barry McGuigan to win the WBA featherweight crown. And again, the chant for Cruz.
Cruz fighting well this round, but just not well enough to be impressive to win the round. And so he's got to do something a little bit more impressive. Again, he backhanded, Paez backhanded, Cruz. He fights from all. The head comes in.
A body block thrown by the offensive lineman, Jorge Baez. We'll be back after these messages.
Today's
manager Dave Gorman telling Steve Cruz, you must win these last two rounds. Gorman in the corner with Arturo Perez. Steve Cruz Sr. This is round 11.
He said use that straight right hand and put him down. Well, he's been trying to land that all fight long, but he hasn't been able to. He has opened, and Cruz has opened this round with more fire than he has since that one round. And Gorman is right. It's not just these two rounds. He almost needs a knockout. At least unofficially on my scorecard, I have him behind 97 to 92, which would mean he has to have a knockout. I'm sure it's much closer on other scorecards.
Most boxing people felt that the strength of Paez would be the difference, that he would wear Cruz down, and to this point, that is accurate.
Wait a minute, they're finally taking a round away. One point away. Well, they've warned him. There were more warnings from the referee than the Gulf Coast gets during hurricane season. This guy has an inexhaustible supply of patience. He just kept warning him. He had to take a point. Had to. And he did. Big point in a championship match.
That's an excessive number of fouls committed by Paez. It is the referee's judgment, and he finally decided to take 1 point away.
Well, I don't think anybody, even his corner, can complain about that. He has been warned incessantly since the first bell, and he does foul a lot. Does the champion, Paez. Now, if he takes this one, if Cruz can take this round with that point off, is getting within range. Oh, Paez looks very, very upset and frustrated. He just made a face like saying, what is this guy doing?
Paez also not one to accept the breaking technique of referee Robert Gonzalez, just shirks it off. He's been hitting on the break.
Just like a teacher has reprimanded him and he stops fighting.
Well, we don't know the severity of it unless we see the scorecard, but it can make it a potential 10-7 round. We'll be right back.
Up here.
Watch the low blow, not really flagrantly low, nothing compared to what they've been doing, and they took a point. That's the accumulation of all those blows and the impatience of the referee. Big 10-7 round makes this up for grabs. This is the championship on this 12th round.
Well, we just checked with the referee, Robert Gonzalez, and while it appeared he indicated that both points were being taken from Paez, he now says he took one from Cruz. One from Paez.
Oh.
And he went to each judge to make that clear. That did not appear to be the indication.
These guys are really laying it out. I guess both of them haven't gotten the message because that effectively doesn't alter anything. If they took one away from each and neutralized each other, forget about it.
This is the 12th and final round with Jorge Paez defending his IBF featherweight title against Steve Cruz. elimination from Paez, who's laying it all out here in the 12th round.
That's the strangest situation I've seen with a referee. He did not clearly indicate that. I'm wondering if both corners know. Good hook. But the first wobble I've seen in Cruz's legs. Good hook connected by Paez. Referee is now beginning to act a little strange. He stepped between them for no reason at all after that hook landed.
Well, he did warn Cruz again for a low blow, and he has been warning Cruz along the way, but not as frequently as Paez. That is the time remaining in this 12th and final round.
Uppercuts especially, beginning to bother Steve. Steve Cruz giving ground, looking much weaker now.
And now Paez painting Cruz. Big finish here for Paez, under a minute to go. We're live from El Paso, Texas. Marv Albert with the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco. And Paez pulling his way. Again, the referee Gonzalez steps between. Cut landed by Paez as we come up on 20 seconds left of the fight.
I think you can safely say it's the strength of Paez that has overcome the ring generalship of Cruz. We'll see that in a moment when the decisions are announced. Quite unofficially, I have Paez retaining his title.
Final seconds of the fight, and an elbow into kiss by Gonzalez as this bout concludes. So a foul-filled 12 rounds for the IBF featherweight crown. And we'll be back for the decision here in El Paso right after we pause for these words. Let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 championship rounds of boxing, we have a unanimous decision, and here are the point totals. Judge at ringside, David McCullough, scores the bout 117-108. Juan Jose Ramirez scores the bout 114-111. Patricia Jarman scores the bout 116-111 in favor of the winner and still champion, Jorge Maromero Paez.
So a unanimous, decisive decision in favor of Jorge Paez, who retains his IBF featherweight champion and goes into his theatrics. Jorge Paez out of Mexicali, Mexico, now with a record of 30-2, and Steve Cruz drops to 33-4. Very rugged bout. Paez was put down for the first time in his career by Cruz back in the second round, and Paez came storming out in round three. It quieted down through rounds four and five, and then heated up once again, and Paez has retained his title. Thanks to our producer, David Neal, director, J.D. Hansen. This is Marv Albert with the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco from El Paso, Texas, saying so long for NBC's Sports World.
Hey, Paez spent the summer training, or has he spent the summer watching Batman again and again and again? Jorge also appears to be wearing a skirt, which will serve him well if they ever make a Batgirl movie. Paez defends his title in a decision over Steve Cruz. Not only does Jorge give you quality boxing for your dollar, he also presents an entertainment spectacular. Makes you want to root for the Joker.